area below the Moose Club is called the Moose Flats, and it's a very shallow area, and when the lake's high, it's really good fishing because there's a lot of structure and stuff there. That was all bare. There were 600 acres bare in the Moose Flats, and tumbleweeds, thistles started growing there, and nobody thought much of it.
On the morning of November 8, 1989, the residents of Mobridge awoke to a blizzard, not of snow, but tumbleweeds. The previous night brought a powerful windstorm to Mobridge with gusts up to 90 miles an hour, and with the strong winds came the tumbleweeds from Moose Flats.
Yeah, southwest part of town. The wind was so powerful, it just forced them, and as they got caught, they packed in between houses and into entryways and garage, between houses and garages, and from house to house to house in a block, they were all blocked in. Well, one of the ladies, she was Darlene Zahn, woke up in the middle of the night and she thought there was a hailstorm because this ping, ping, ping was hitting her trailer house. When she woke up in the morning, it's tumbleweeds, and they're packed in. She can't get out of her trailer house.
As people attempted to emerge from their homes, they realized just how many tumbleweeds had invaded their community.
10th Street, and this car is just edging along the edge because 10th Street is covered with tumbleweeds. The viaduct down here was totally plugged. You couldn't drive under the viaduct. They said a lot of them were like 8 feet high, but there was one place that were like stacked 15 feet high. It was really, really intense.
So what do you do with 600 acres of tumbleweeds jammed into every crack and crevice of half your town? Well, you bale them with a round baler.
I tried crushing them. That didn't seem to work. Some of them just bounced back. They tried driving over them, but they just got caught under things. I mean, with big machinery, I'm not talking about cars, they're talking about big things. That didn't work, so finally, they started baling them. And they baled them up into those big round bales that weigh about 1,200 pounds a piece. And Willie Hepper was doing it, and he used them as a windbreak out where his cattle were.
Once the tumbleweeds were cleaned up, baled, and hauled away, the people of Mobridge could relax a bit and begin to see the humor in what had happened.
After the real danger was over, people decided to take advantage of it. And so we made t-shirts that said Attack of the Tumbleweeds. The bars had drinks that were called tumbleweed drinks. And we made the national news. We made the three major networks. We made Newsweek magazine. We made People magazine. Jay Leno show, did a phone interview with him. But I think he made jokes about it. And one of the ladies said, when he was making jokes about it, it wasn't funny yet. So...